How I feel to be the boss, let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no.
Hey everybody, it's the Coach. This is Madden Football on EA Sports. We're just about set to get started, and this ought to be a good one, between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Indianapolis Colts. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach. First opened back in 2008. There's a look at Lucas Oil Stadium here in downtown Indy. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Indianapolis Colts. It's the final 3 weeks of the season, still plenty to play for here as we're underway in week 15. This fielded at the 2. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. And he'll hope that this is not a sign of what's in store as he has to fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. They'll run with Hunt on second down. And he'll... lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
15 yards as Tampa Bay picks up the first. Late in the season now, MVP chatter starts, and he might be on the fringe. This is always an award that goes quarterback, running back, usually quarterback.
Against him.
A lot of bias. Does he deserve consideration?
He more than deserves consideration because
the Colts are going to get him. Down he goes. Darius Leonard able to record his fifth sack of the season. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Yannick Ngakoue in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. They'll set up a throw. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. It'll be a gain of 17, but even with that, they'll be well short here for fourth down. They'll try and throw for it here. He's got Evans. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer first down. Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 46. They'll set up to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Ballard. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 17 yards on the play and a Buccaneer first down. Looking to throw. This will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
No, I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
That's good for a Buccaneer first, to pick up of 12 yards. Now after the run by Hunt, here's first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. The numbers on the ground for Hunt a week ago. He was, without a doubt, one of the catalysts in that victory.
And he could really be the glue that makes this offense go, because when defenders have to commit to stopping him, that just opens up more opportunities in the passing game.
He completes it to Evans. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Third catch for him on this drive alone, and it'll give him a first down. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter. Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Quarterbacking 101. Never force the ball into double coverage, especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tough.
And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Marquez Valdes-Scantling with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Bucs take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Extra point up and good by Bullock. And that makes the score 7-0. Now Bullock will send this one away after the touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So the Colts now coming out for their opening drive. They'll be led out by their quarterback, a product of NC State. It's Jacoby Brissett.
And what I loved about meeting with him before the game was talking to a guy who takes ownership of his performance. 2 touchdowns, 2 interceptions last week, but all he focused on was the loss, okay? And he did say, if I change my stats a little bit, not necessarily for me to look better, but that'll help my team.
Now the pass finding its way into the hands of Eric Ebron, and he'll be out right at the 35.
Holding offense.
So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. They'll run it now out of the gun. The numbers for him from a week ago, 14 carries, 57 yards.
And partner, I thought it was a lot of fun for us to be able to sit in on their film session with the offensive line. We saw how they blocked it up last week to pretty good success, and we see what their game plan is for this week.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Shaquem Griffin, he was relentless there as he hits home for the sack. Second quarter now from Indianapolis with the homestanding Colts in possession. They're staring up at a 3rd and 9 to start it out. Brissett, that's taken in by Callaway. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first.
Let's go.
That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Bucs are going to take over 1st and 10 deep in their own territory. They'll start with Hunt on the ground. And from the 15, they're able to work this up to the 20 for a pickup of a handful.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
On second down, it's Hunt, and he'll get only a couple up to the 22. The Bucs on 3rd down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. They'll try to run for the first down with Hunt. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. They have the first down with that gain of 4 yards. Back to throw here. Well, partner, none of these, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Darius Leonard in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year. He'll look to throw. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
It's Evans. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. They're going to look to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 11, and this one will be brought back to the 22. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted,
through an opening, and there he goes. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great play there. 78 yards as they are now on the board here in the first half. Well called, well blocked, and then he just made a great play. That's an athlete going a long way.
Yeah, how about the suddenness, too, of just getting there and taking off and going? For the defensive guys, plays like that really hurt.
Point after, right down the middle. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And we are tied at seven. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
10 yards there and a Buccaneer first down. Well, we know he's an electric runner. Earlier this half, you were wondering how they were going to bottle him up at different levels. That was your suggestion. Some mixed results.
Yeah, certainly, because we have seen him bottled up at times. We've seen him play him very well. We've also seen him pop the cork a few times and get out of there, haven't we?
We have indeed. On first down, they'll run with Hunt, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Clock running, the Bucs try to go quickly and get set. Second and nine now. Got an open man, it's Valdez Scantling. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. First down now, but the clock continues to move. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Second and 10. And this is caught by Evans. He's got this to the 30 before being taken down. First down now, but that clock rolling. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And they move this all the way down to the 9. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Get your backs to the goal line. I can hear my high school coach right now. This is when force meets force. Got to be physical in order to win this battle.
Yeah, that's where the physicality pays off. A nice job forcing the contact and forcing the incompletion.
Yeah, Coach Ford would have loved that play.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Two incompletions haven't moved him any closer. And likely throwing again, you'd have to think, on third and goal here. The quick slant caught. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. A field goal would break the tie, but look at this. Instead, they're going to go for it on fourth and goal. Again, he'll drop the throw. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucks. Mike Evans. Touchdown number 22 on the season. And the Bucks have taken the lead. Bullock good on the extra point.
And that lead is now 7 with a chance to go to 8 or more if they want to get crazy here, which we don't expect. But I just know the way the game's being played with the analytics, there's going to be a lot more of going for 2 in a lot of situations, isn't there?
Yeah, there's going to be. And I think their focus here, they don't want to give up anything going into the lockers on the other end. Just a little bit of time left on the clock.
Hit it.
Touchdown, Indianapolis. Officially an even 100 yards coast-to-coast on the kick return as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Such an electric play, so much fun to watch, and you need all 11 guys in sync for that to be successful, don't you?
Without a doubt. That's teamwork, to be able to put it all together. But that play is really probably the most exciting 10 seconds in football.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Time here for likely one play, and then these two teams will head to the locker room all even.
And you know the play caller's just feeling it right now. Let's go ahead and go for this one. A big shot.
He's got daylight. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
Boy, the action just coming fast and furious right now. If you got up to go get a drink from the fridge, you picked the wrong time. Too long. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This will be taken in at the 1. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Out come the Colts. They'll have it first here to start quarter number 3. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Play fake. Brissett. He's going to sling this deep downfield. It's caught inside the 25. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Last play, they didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. Now they gain almost 40 yards here. Out of the gun, Brissett. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around a 30. Shaquille Barrett, a milestone sack for him as it moves him past Hall of Famer Lawrence Taylor, who finished his career with 132 and a half. On second down now, it's Gibson. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Here's Brissett. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Shaquille Barrett, a milestone sack for him as it moves him past Hall of Famer Lawrence Taylor, who finished his career with 132 and a half. And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Hey, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. They'll begin the drive with Hunt. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
Here's Hunt. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. It's a gain of 11, and the Bucs have a first down. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. They'll get about 4 as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line. And they're going to speed things up here. 2nd and 6. Flushed out right. He's going to take off with it. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts' 44-yard line.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
They'll look to throw here on 1st down. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Howard has the 1st down and then some. That one covers 24 yards. It's a 1st down.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Ronald Jones, his 2nd touchdown on the season as the Buccaneers tack onto their lead. Extra point up and good by Bullock. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So that drives 7 plays in length. And it's Ronald Jones that polishes it off with a touchdown run. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they...
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. 9 yards the pick up there, and it's a 1st down. They'll run on 1st down. Gibson. In on the stop, it was the UCF product, Shaquem Griffin. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Colts, so they've got the football, but they've got work to do. Trailing here as we begin the 4th quarter. On 2nd and 9, Brissett. They'll get 9 there as that sets them up better for 3rd down. Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his 3rd and 1. Here's Brissett. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Shaquil Barrett in there yet again. What else is new? He continues to rewrite the record book in single-season sacks. And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Brissett to throw for it on 4th.
Well, someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks. He came into the game in the top 5. Now you add 2 more to his total.
The Colts unable to convert here on 4th down. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. On 1st down, punt. Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40. Charles, you'd said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top five offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too good, isn't it?
They really are, because no matter what you do to make an adjustment on defense, they've had an answer for it.
And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. They'll look to throw.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag.
And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucks. Mike Evans with touchdown number 23 here on the year as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Bullock good on the extra point. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff position? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
You give him 5 yards there, and it's enough for the first. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. To throw, Brissett. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. And in the air once more, it's Brissett. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. The Colts on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is third and 10. They'll throw again. Brissett, he's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Now Brissett, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Shaquille Barrett getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Brissett looking middle, and it's incomplete. Eric Rowe that time able to knock that pass away. The Colts on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and 19. From the gun, here's Brissett. This is intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure's been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They'll run on first down. It's Hunt. A gain of 3, second down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. Here's a 2nd and 7. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Yannick Ngakoue racking up sack number 12 for him on the year. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. Now back to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Bruce Arians takes a shot there, but his guys come up empty. And the Colts are going to get the football at outstanding field position. So they were really trying to put the nail in the coffin there already with this lead here in the fourth. But they didn't. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Now this is Callaway on the receiving end. And he takes it all the way down to the three. A big play there on the catch and run. 54 yards. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Antonio Callaway, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Colts are able to cut into this lead.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
And the Bucs are on this one. And that should just about do it. Kareem Hunt and the rest of the offense making their way back out there. And as the numbers show, he really wasn't in the mix at the beginning, but they've got him in the rotation now, and it's proved a good move.
And that's what happens when you're a good player. There's a lot more attention drawn to you, and it's obvious that they had him in their game plan on defense, not letting him get off to a good start, but he's found a way so far here in the second half.
That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Chris Godwin with his 13th touchdown of the year and second of the game as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that, but there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know who was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
Off the play fake. Here's Brissett. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Brissett sets to throw it, and that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Throwing, Brissett. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. And we've got a timeout. 9 seconds remaining. Brissett now 10 of 17 throwing the ball. He's got a first and 10. Brissett again. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A big offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Buccaneers, the final 2 weeks are going to tell the story for them as they...
Off the hook, and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. Bobby, tell your mama, and tell your daddy, and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama, and tell your daddy, and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Come get some, if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop.